Hi everyone, in this video I'm going to show you how to create a Google map that has your square boundary and your square point count locations on it. So to get started, you have to go to the Atlas website. This is where you'll go in order to download the information you need for your Google map. Under Tools and Resources, click Square Resources. And that will take you to the map of North America. You need to zoom in on the square that you want. I'm going to zoom in on a square here near Madoc. And once you zoom in enough, then the square will appear on the map. Confirm it's the one you want. If you need to look up, check the name. It should be up here in red. So you'll see the boundary and you'll see all the point count locations. There will be a whole bunch of options available now, or tools available for the square. You want to find the one that talks about Google Earth. So the download point count coordinates, Google Earth KML KMZ format. And despite the name on the link, it does give you not just the point counts, but also the square boundary. So click that, and it will give you an option to download it. So you have to choose where on your computer to save the file, note the name of the file. In this case, it's called Waypoint 7. You can call it whatever you want. Click Save. Once it's downloaded, then you can go into Google Maps. So I'm going to create a new tab here, Google Maps. Now, for this to work, you need to have a Google account and be logged in. If you're not logged in, there should be a little icon in the top corner. In this case, I'm already logged in. Click the menu option and scroll down to your places. And then on the new menu that pops up for your places, click on maps and then create a map. So now we're onto our new map that we've just created, and we can give it a name. You can give it a description if you want. I'm not going to bother with that right now. And then we're going to edit the first layer. So we're going to import the file we just downloaded. So click the import button. New window will pop up and you can click the select a file from your computer button and navigate to it. The other option, if you have a browser running the way I do and you can see the file sitting there, you can actually click and drag it right into this area. It will upload the file, and once it's loaded, it should zoom right in to the square. So you can see the square boundary. If you hover over it, should highlight, and you can see all these little individual points. Now from here, there's lots of things you can do to customize the map. So for instance, you can change the look of them. So we can change them to be individual styles. So that's how they are by default, and we could change how each one looks. You know, we could change the symbol, could give it a color, whatever. You can do whatever you want. And you can also just have them all look the same. So I'm going to change it to uniform style. And you can also label them if you want, but I'm not going to label them. It'll look a bit too messy. Then the square boundary is another thing you can edit. It's only one square boundary here, obviously. You can change the color. I'm going to change it to purple. And you can change how thick the border is, make it easier or harder to see the border. And you can change how transparent it is. So you could make it totally impossible to see through, or you could totally make it transparent, whatever you choose. Now the final option that you can change is the base map. And you could change it to like a satellite view if you want. I find that to be the most helpful. And so there you go. You've got your Atlas map made in Google Maps, and you can add, if you wanted to, you could import another file as another layer. You could make new maps for different squares if you cover more than one square. Once you've made them, then you're able to open them up on your phone if you want. As long as you have a data connection, you're able to navigate around to the different point counts and things like that.
All right, now that you've created a map in Google Maps on your computer, I'm going to show you how to access it while you're on your phone. And I'm showing you using an Android device, but the process is the exact same on an iOS device. And one thing to keep in mind is this requires an internet connection. So if you don't have a data plan on your phone, or you're going to be in areas where you're offline, then this likely is not an option for you. You're better off to use some other method for navigating when you're atlasing. Anyways, to use this method, open up Google Maps app. And then on this screen, you want to click the little bookmark icon above the word saved. And then scroll down to the very bottom, and there's a little icon in the bottom right for maps. Click that. And here, what you want to do is click Atlas Square Map. That's your, or whatever you named your saved map, and it'll zoom in on your square map, and you're ready to go. Now, if you are heading to go out atlasing, theoretically, this should save for offline use, as long as you don't completely close the Google Maps app. But it's a bit risky if you're going to be out in an area without service. So, as I said, you want to plan some alternative navigation methods. But this is one option for you.